Gambir, a herb adding youthful vigor to man. The same energy exudes from Gambir's shop houses, erected since colonial days. People squeezing past motorbikes, cars, and lorries, over-parking each other, selling, buying, and unloading. Yet, still smiles at me, flashing questions like, where are you from? How many times do we take a break from busyness and notice what is in front of us? Hutch! Sneezes snitch in as nose feasts on yellows, browns, and reds, labeled as tepung kari kurma, chili kasar, dal kacang muda, and tepung jintan putih. As camera captures finger snapping cinnamon sticks on my phone screen, my memories thus brought me back to this walkway as a little girl tugging at mama's shirt while she bargained with an Indian uncle for turmeric powder. Stepping into Masjid India, a certain stillness hushes, hustling out from this hidden square, mooring on Moore's wall, a man lies on parquet printed ground. Do we carve out an inner cave in cramped commotion to rest? An old blind pakchi, sunk up on his head, sits at the entrance holding a metal mark. Mama used to walk this alleyway to India Street, dropping a cent or two, even when her purse was tight. She always says he needed it more. How many of us stop giving when life becomes hard to bear? In a dark hideaway, broken brick flooring, a long antique cast iron bell-shaped fire extinguisher looms over me. Breeze streams from hexagon-shaped stone openings on the wall. Cobweb windows creak open to pigeons crowding on a tree. The kids who was hosted in this storage room, perhaps from the Arab school next door, did they have the same view back then? Did they wish for wings to escape? Or did they hope to go home no matter where they ended in, their roots stronger than the wind? Clamoring, tiptoeing through attics of boxes on whole wooden planks, and steady steel railings, perhaps older than mama. The Tao Kenyon tells me in Hokkien to be careful, like a popo wood. How endearing, just like the outlet's name, Sweetheart Enterprise. What if everyone is as warm to strangers? My eyes bumped into I love you everyday jelly pudding plastered on a used cardboard. When was the last time we expressed I love you to our loved ones? Do we wait until they have passed on like the first owners of this place? Rolls of patterned fabric lying against rusty metal gates of fire, rebuilt after catching fire. Touching, printed, polyester reminded me of taking buses with mama from Berlin to hunt for cute cartoon cotton tops so she could make his pajamas and bed sheets. Every texture, fold, and flap felt magical. Do we stop being at all to at things surrounding us? left our hearts grown cold after being burnt. A friend toyed with tubes, holding the very same fabric as swords, perhaps trying to be Star Wars heroes with his brothers. Do we still play without constraints like kids do? If not, what stopped us? The shops in Gambir go all the way in, deep and rich, as if they never end, like the history held by the generations that inherit them. After a visit, an heirloom of reflection lingers on. What about us? What do we want to leave behind? What do we want to leave behind? Thank you.